So here we are, Sunday morning, almost 8 o'clock. So I was flying to get the truck yesterday. I had a flight for 6 a.m. Well, it got canceled, I believe, due to fog, and it's kind of foggy right now. And they bumped me down to 2 in the afternoon for my flight, so I got down to Georgia about 4, and then it was about 5 by the time I got to the truck. So it was pretty dark out. Got the truck. All the lights and everything were working. I drove up the road to this gas station and got some diesel. Well, when I was filling it up, the headlights quit working. So I pretty much just pulled over here on this road and slept. Slept back here. And just waking up now and have to hit the key and see if she fires up. Let's hope. Well, see what happens. But here it is. Here for fuel is Pilot out here in Tennessee, and my passenger tank is pretty much empty, but my driver's side tank is full and overflowing, so obviously it's pulling fuel. Passenger tank and returning the engine fuel on the driver tank, and it's not equalizing. There was a bunch of pressure when I took the cap off to fuel it up on the other side, so I'm guessing the vents are plugged. So I pulled the rubber hose off of them. As you can see, I can't get in there to remove them and do the check ball. So I'm just pulling these plugs out to vent the tanks. It's probably going to make a mess, but hopefully not too bad. I'm bleeding already. So there's your update. Otherwise, she's running pretty good. want these caps to come off. Lug nuts are all tight. It's got some vibrations going down the road, but probably just old truck stuff. Oh yeah. Just checking stuff over. Not very airtight in that cab. Rather breezy. But looking pretty good. This windshield wiper does work. The one on the other side does not. In fact, there's not one there. But sprayed some Rain-X on a windshield. Haven't had to use the wiper yet. They're air, if you don't know. Potholes. the fuel tank vent situation is fixed. I've only used like a quarter tank of diesel. And before, it was just sucking the fuel down like crazy. So, keep my fingers crossed. Even if it does make a mess on the tanks. Haven't tried the CB yet. Don't really want to mess with too much. Being, you know, hours and hours away from home. Before dark or not. So last Sunday, I was, like I mentioned, the headlights went out in the truck, so I could only drive until dark. People were flashing their headlights at me, actually, because it was getting fairly dark. And I was talking to one of my buddies who had a friend who lived in Salina, Ohio. And they said I could park my truck at their place, so I parked it there Sunday, and my friend gave me a drive home, 2-hour drive home. Thanks, Bruce. And, so then I worked all week and I had to work Saturday, but I was off today, Sunday, and went down there and picked it up and drove her on home. So that's why there's a gap.
Well, here she goes.
Yep.
I don't know which key it was. Let you figure it out.
That's a good noise.
Ugh.
these trucks, Marvin's. Look at the back of the Marvin sleeper. Was that a 1693 Katniss 352? Single axle, cool trailer too. The sun really sucks. I think this is a Marvin here. Could be wrong. Yep, Marvin. Another cool trailer. Cummins. Some kind of a Cummins in there. GMC. I love this A model right here. I'd love to open the trucks up, but the owner isn't around. I've got permission to be here, but I don't want to go messing around his stuff. Guessing that's a Mac. Thank you. Dodge cab over. Another one behind it. This thing. Yeah, he's got a lot of cool trailers right here. Try to get on the other side of the sun and get some better shots of some of this. Another Dodge. International. I believe those are like the predecessor to my Transtar 4300. Another Marmon. Several Marmons. This one's like a twin of the other one. Looks like a Detroit in there. Oh, that Marvin's got a back window. Huh. Wet tank on there. It's got like one of them salter things. Another International. This trailer's awesome. Detroit in there. So here we go. See if we can make the final 2 hours home. It was taking a while to build air back there, but it's building air and popping off like it should. Seems like probably got a couple leaks draining it down, but today it was supposed to get up about 40 degrees, but they sure don't seem like it's going to. spot to set my phone. Tried all the gears in the 13 speed yet. I'd like to be a little closer to home. In case I fuck up and blow a U-joint out or something. Well, made her home. Finally. I did lose the top of the sissy stick here, coming home. Those will be coming off anyways. So I'll have to get these lights working and wash her and clean her up and all that good stuff. So, see you later. So cleaning the truck out. Got a pile of stuff here. I'll show you the sleeper a little bit more. It's pretty neat, you know. This switch doesn't do anything. Got a little map light down here at the bottom. Got a cabinet door. There's the tank for the water for the sink. Little towel rack. Here's a sink. I don't know if that's a cup holder back there. I don't know. I don't know what all these wires are hanging out for. Something out there. But we got a nice little light mirror. Got a vent for your heat or AC. Of course, we got a cigarette lighter. Got a little shelf up here, curtain, some map lights, speaker. I believe these are just like a coat hanger. Hang your shirt up there. They're not for the bed. From what I can tell, the bed swings down. I already messed with it a little bit, but here's a latch for the bed. You know, same latch that they got right there. I haven't been able to get this door open. There's the window. Come to the other side. Got some more map lights underneath the top bunk. Little cubby. So we got a door down here. Opens. We got a nice little table right here. That's pretty cool. Bigger door. Looks like somebody left a jacket and some clothes in here. I'll have to go through there in a second. Come up here and we got a clock. Jensen quality digital clock. AM/FM radio. Bodies by Benz, Fort Wayne, Indiana. Here we got the heater controls. Another cigarette lighter. That's pretty neat. There's a voltage gauge for the batteries. You know, another vent there. Look out the windows, see the top of the truck. Looks pretty friggin' dirty. I'm guessing this is for the radio, maybe. That's right over here, an antenna. Ow. Let's see. Look at here. Brewer Racing, Columbus GA. Umbrella. Can't tell what's on that. Some kind of baggie here. I have to untie that. No idea what's in this. Oh, a bunch of wristbands. Tube town? So are these brand new, or are these like from the races they used to go to? I've been told this truck's an old NASCAR hauler. Excuse me. And it definitely seems like it is. Is this a international harvester part factory? Or is this just some random... Can't tell what that is. Taiwan? Oh. Huh. It's like a cabinet latch. Probably for this... one right here, because the dealy whopper's missing. Jar. Nothing in it. And an old belt. Still pretty neat. All right, I opened up the umbrella real quick. It says ARCA. ARCA Racing. I believe Andy Belmont used to own this truck. So maybe that's from him. Pretty neat. Cleaning more of the truck out. I'm emptying this out. There's some miscellaneous nuts and bolts and light bulbs and whatnot in there. And then I found some photos. I do not know who this gentleman is. Car number 10. Safe to say this thing definitely was a NASCAR hauler. Found some packets inside there. Got an automotive diesel engine operation and maintenance manual. US and Canada. This truck was built in Canada. We got here international electrical circuit diagrams. This is awesome. Jacob's engine brake. This is awesome. And registration card. Oh. Sounds like it's for the fifth wheel. Hang on a sec. Okay. Come on. Fontaine fifth wheel. 5-year warranty. I think that's expired. Yep. Fontaine and wedge lock, no slack fifth wheels. Still pretty neat.